this video, we are going to study about infrared spectroscopy. In this video, we will cover introduction, infrared spectrum, ranges and regions, and principle of infrared spectroscopy. So, first of all, we have to study what is this spectroscopy. Let's see the definition. Study of interaction of electromagnetic radiations with matter. We know that electromagnetic radiations are gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet, visible, infrared, microwaves and radio waves. See, here we will study the interaction of electromagnetic radiations with matter. See here, matter means the sample which is under study. Here, if we pass some of the radiations through this sample which consists of molecules, then we will get some information about this sample. Some information about this sample structure and the functional group of this molecules present in this sample. So, now we know that study of interaction of electromagnetic radiations with matter is known as spectroscopy. Now, let us study about electromagnetic spectrum. These are the introduction and basic things about the spectroscopy. So, what is electromagnetic spectrum means? Here, different type of radiations are arranged according to their wavelengths and frequencies. It is called as electromagnetic spectrum. Here, our special interest is about infrared spectroscopy. Now, let us study about the relationship between wavelength and frequency. It is very, very important. See, energy of the photon. Photon is nothing but light. Energy of the photon is given by E is equals to h nu, where h is a Planck's constant and nu is the frequency in hertz. Here, you can see that energy and frequency are directly proportional. That means if the energy increases, frequency also increases. So, in this direction, that means radio waves to gamma rays. Well, coming from radio waves to gamma rays, energy increases and frequency also increases. Now, let us consider the second equation. That means the value of frequency, that is nu is equals to c by lambda. Here, frequency is given by speed of light divided by lambda. Lambda is nothing but wavelength. So, let us substitute the value of wavelength in the equation 1. See, here we are substituting the value of lambda, that is value of nu, that is c by lambda in the equation 1. So, we will get E is equals to h into c by lambda. So, here we have got that by substituting equation 2 in equation 1, we will get E is equals to h c by lambda. It is the equation 3rd. Here, we know that lambda is the wavelength and energy of the photon. Here, energy and this wavelength are inversely proportional. That means if the energy increases, wavelength decreases. So, that is given here. See, from gamma rays to radio waves, coming from gamma rays to radio waves, wavelength increases. But while going from radio waves to gamma rays, energy and frequency increases. Why? Because energy and frequency are directly proportional to each other, while wavelength is inversely proportional to the energy. This is about the basic introduction. Now, the important topic comes here. We should know about the wave number. Wave number is given by nu bar. This is given as 1 by lambda. We know that wave number is the number of waves in unit distance. So, it is given by nu bar is equals to 1 by lambda. Here, lambda is nothing but wavelength. So, if we need the value of lambda, it will become 1 by nu bar. So, let's substitute this value in the equation 3. So, if I substitute the value of lambda in the equation 3, I will get E is equals to hc nu bar. Here you can see energy and wave number is directly proportional. That means if the energy increases, wave number also increases. This is very, very important. It is if the energy increases, wave number also increases. This is the very important relationship for this infrared spectroscopy. Now, let us talk about our topic, that is infrared. Here, see that infrared radiations are present between the microwaves and visible rays. See here microwaves are present on the left side, where visible rays present on the right side of the infrared radiations, that is infrared region. Now let's read these 2 points. These are very important. Here microwaves cause the rotation of a molecule. We know that when the microwaves are passed through the sample under investigation, so they'll cause the molecules to rotate, while UV visible cause the electronic transitions. That means they cause the excitation of electrons from the lower energy level to the higher energy level. Let us see the second point. In UV and visible regions of the electromagnetic spectrum, electrons are excited from the lower energy molecular orbital to the higher ones. But here we are studying about the infrared radiations. When these infrared radiations, if we pass the infrared radiations through the sample which is under study, these infrared radiations does not cause the electrons to excite from lower energy level to the higher energy level, but these can cause the vibrations. So this is also called as vibrational spectroscopy. See here, if the two atoms are present, it is an atom and it is one atom, there is a bond between these two atoms. So when we pass the infrared radiations through this molecule, then this covalent bond will start to vibrate. Then will start to vibrate like this. That means infrared radiation can cause the excitation of molecules from lower to the higher vibration levels. That means from lower vibration levels to, it can excite to higher vibration levels like this. So these infrared radiations does not have sufficient energy as that of the UV and visible regions to cause electronic transition, but they can excite the molecule from lower to the higher vibrational energy levels. This is the very important point. So what is the importance of this infrared spectroscopy? Why this infrared spectroscopy is used? Means it is used to determine the functional group present in the molecule. This is the very important application of this infrared spectroscopy. This spectroscopy is useful for determining the functional group which is present in the molecule. Remember that in infrared spectroscopy, we will pass infrared radiations through the sample under study, and we will get the information about the sample under study. So here we are determining the functional group present in the molecule by using infrared spectroscopy. Let us study about the infrared ranges. See here, in this infrared ranges, the important regions are near IR, mid IR and far IR. Here, the most of the vibrations occurs at the mid IR. So this mid IR is very important while comparing to near IR and far IR. Mid IR is very important. So let us study about the regions which are present in this infrared. Here, first region is photographic region. This region is not mentioned in all the books, but it is also very important. So first, coming to the photographic region, this range from visible to 0.8 μm. We know that beside the infrared region we are having visible region. So this range from visible to 0.8 μm. See here, you can see 0.8 μm. This ranges from visible to 0.8 μm. So next, coming to the near infrared region, this is from 0.8 to 2.5 μm. See, 0.8 μm to 2.5 μm. This is also called as overtone region. And the third one is the mid infrared region. This is also called as vibration rotation region. This region is very important. It ranges from 2.5 to 15 μm, that is 4000 to 667 cm inwards. This region is particularly important since the vibrations induced in organic molecules are observed in this region. Vibration and rotational transitions occur in this region. So this is very, very important. In the infrared spectroscopy, we will specially study about this region only, that is from 4000 to 667 cm inverse, the most important region of this spectroscopy. Here only most of the organic molecules can absorb the radiation and cause vibrations. So this is very, very important. Then coming to the fourth region, that is far infrared region. This ranges from 15 to 200 μ, that is 667 to 50 cm inverse. Far infrared region is useful for inorganic studies. So you can see that in the infrared spectroscopy, this μm units are usually not used, but this centimeter inwards unit is commonly used. Centimeter inwards is nothing but wave number. So I have already said you that energy is directly proportional to the wave number. That means if the energy increases, wave number also increases. These two are directly proportional. Now let us convert the value of this μm to the centimeter inverse, that is in the form of wave number. These are also very important while plotting the graph. Remember that 1 μm is equals to 10 raised to minus 4 centimeter, and I will also say some other conversions, that is 1 centimeter is equals to 10 raised to minus 2 meter, and 1 millimeter is equals to 10 raised to minus 3 meter. 1 μm, that is 1 micrometer, is equals to 10 raised to minus 6 meter, and 1 nanometer is equals to 10 raised to minus 9 meter. 1 angstrom is equals to 10 raised to minus 10 meter, and 1 picometer is equals to 10 raised to minus 12 meter. These are very, very important for the conversion purpose. And also 1 micrometer is equals to 10 raised to minus 4 centimeter. This is also very important. So let us convert μm to centimeter inverse. I have already said that the important region in this infrared is mid IR, that is from 2.5 μm to 15 μm. So let's convert this μm to centimeter inverse, that is in the form of wave number. We know that wave number is given as, that is it is a wave number which is expressed in the centimeter inverse, which is given as 1 by lambda. It is the wavelength. We already know that. Here we have seen that lambda, that is wavelength, is given in the form of μm. So here we are converting wavelength to wave number. Please remember it. So here mu bar is equals to 1 by lambda. That is, we should get the answer in centimeter, and this is given in the centimeter inverse. Now let us see 2.5 μm. See here, mu bar centimeter inverse is equals to 1 by, the value is 2.5 μm. We have to convert this μm into centimeter. We know that 1 μm is equals to 1 μm is equals to 10 raised to minus 4 centimeter. So mu bar centimeter inverse is equals to 1 by 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 4 centimeter. So when we solve this, we will get mu bar is equals to 4000 centimeter inverse. Now here 2.5 μm is represented as 4000 centimeter inverse in the wave number. Now coming to the 15 mu m, that is same, mu bar is equals to 1 by lambda. Here it is given in the mu m, we have to convert it to centimeter. This is expressed in centimeter inverse. So mu bar is equals to 1 by, that is 15 mu m, 1 divided by 15 into 1 mu m is equals to 10 raised to minus 4 centimeter. So when we solve this, we will get the answer 667 centimeter inverse. So mu bar is equals to 667 centimeter inverse. So you can say that mid IR range is from 4000 to 667 centimeter inverse, which is represented in the wave number. Also tell why this wave number is used in this infrared spectroscopy graph. Now let us see the graph of this IR spectroscopy. Here this graph is percentage transmittance versus wave number. So we have already seen that mu m is converted to centimeter inverse, that is wave number, for the purpose of this graph only. Why? Because the main reason chemists prefer to use wave numbers as units is that they are directly proportional to the energy. I have already said that wave number and energy are directly proportional. So higher the wave number corresponds to higher energy. So these are easy to compare. Wavelengths, that is mu m values, can also be used. But wavelengths are used means sometimes it becomes difficult to predict the difference in the two closely lying peaks on the wavelength scale. So the value is very less, that is from 2.5 to 15 mu m, the value is wavelength. So from 2.5 to 15 mu m, here the value is given in the wavelength. So if we consider this as unit means, if we plot the graph, then two peaks will closely lie to each other. Sometimes they can also overlap with each other. To overcome this problem, we have taken the unit as wave number, that is from 4000 to 667 centimeter inverts. We can also use wavelengths, but it sometimes become difficult to predict the difference in two closely lying peaks. So we are taking wave number as the unit. Here the IR spectroscopy graph is percentage transmittance versus wave number. On the vertical axis we are having transmittance, and on the x axis we are having wave number, that is in the form of centimeter inverts. Here let us see the spectrum. Here each dip, here is a dip and here is a dip and here is a dip. Each dip in the spectrum is called as band or a peak. Band or peak. See, these peaks are inverted in shape. Why? Because here on the vertical axis we are having percentage transmittance. What is transmittance? It describes how much light passes through the sample. If I take this sample and here we are passing the radiations, it describes how much of the radiations are passing, that means how much of light passes through the sample, is given by the transmittance. So here you can observe that this line indicates here is a 100% transmittance of light is present, and this dip indicates that radiation is absorbed by the sample. Let us take a simple example to understand it better. So here I have taken ethanol. It is given by C2H5OH. This is the structure. So here the vibrations occurs due to CH, CO and OH. Now let us consider the vibration range of this OH. The vibration range of this OH is 2950 centimeter inverts. So here if I consider this dip or peak is for OH means, that means OH is absorbed by the infrared radiations, that is from 2950 to 2850 in this region. If I get a peak or dip means, then the meaning is that OH is absorbed here. So this line indicates that there is no absorption at all, but while coming here this OH is absorbed, so here we are getting a band or peak. And the absorption of radiations lowers the percentage transmittance, so we are getting an inverted graph. That means transmittance is lowered by the absorption. See here, absorption of radiation lowers the percentage transmittance. That's why we are getting inverted peak here in the infrared spectroscopy. The reason you can write it as, on the vertical axis we are having percentage transmittance. So while the absorption takes place, the percentage transmittance is lower, so we are getting the inverted peak in the infrared spectroscopy. Now infrared spectrum consists of two regions, that is functional group region and fingerprint region. Here functional group region ranges from 4000 to 1300 centimeter inwards, whereas fingerprint region ranges from 1300 to 667 centimeter inwards. This unit is very important in the infrared. Please remember it. Now let us see the difference between functional group region and fingerprint region. Here if I consider two compounds which are having the same functional group, let us consider the same functional group as X. The compound 1 is also having the X functional group, and the compound 2 is also having the same, that is X functional group. So in the functional group region, functional groups are identified in the form of a absorption bands. If the two compounds are having same functional group, means this functional group region will not differentiate them. But in the fingerprint region, what happens means, if the two compounds are having same functional group, means also it can differentiate them. So here for the functional group region, we can write two compounds having same functional group show similar absorption band in this region. So here we can have the confusion. If the two compounds with same functional groups are present, means so that can be differentiated by using fingerprint region. It is different for different compounds. If the two compounds are having the same functional group, means also to differentiate between them, we will use fingerprint region. This is very important. Now coming to the next point, it is impossible for any two different compounds except enantiomers to have precisely the same infrared spectrum. Until and unless they are enantiomers, they will have different infrared spectrums. But if they are enantiomers, they will have same infrared spectrum. They cannot be differentiated by this infrared spectrum. So now let us see what are these enantiomers. We know that enantiomers are the pair of molecules that exist in two forms that are mirror images of one another but cannot be superimposed on one other. Here let us consider D-lactic acid and L-lactic acid. See, this is the structure of D-lactic acid and this is the structure of L-lactic acid. These two are the mirror images of each other, and these cannot be superimposed on each other. Now let us study about the principle of this infrared spectroscopy. We know that the absorption of infrared radiations cause an excitation of molecule from lower to the higher vibrational levels. We have already seen that the molecule will excite from lower vibrational energy level to the higher vibrational energy level in the infrared spectroscopy. That means when the radiations are passed through the sample, then there is a vibrational changes, that is excitation of molecules from lower to higher vibrational levels when we pass infrared radiations. And the first point here is, the infrared spectra is considered as vibrational rotational spectra. We know that most of the vibrations in organic molecules are caused in the mid infrared region. That region is called as vibrational rotational region. So the infrared spectra is considered as vibrational rotational spectra. This is very important. Now coming to the second point, all the bonds in a molecule are not capable of absorbing infrared energy, but only those bonds which are accompanied by change in dipole moment will absorb in the infrared region. This is very important. if the molecule is infrared active means it should have change in dipole moment. It should have change in dipole moment, then it is called as infrared active. If there is no change in dipole moment means they are infrared inactive. So let us see it by an example. We know that what is dipole? We know that it is the measurement of polarity. Here you have to remember that the molecule should be polar. That means electronegativity difference should be present between the molecules. Then only infrared radiations will be absorbed by the molecule. Then it is called as infrared active. The first and foremost important thing is that electronegativity difference should be there. Then only dipole moment will exist. Examples, that is CO, NH, OH are having electronegativity difference and these exhibits dipole moment. So they are having vibration transitions. They are IR active. While coming to the C, single bond C bonds in symmetrical alkenes and alkynes, IR is inactive. Why? Because there is no dipole moment and there is no electronegativity difference and these molecules are not polar. So C, single bond C bonds in symmetrical alkenes and alkynes or IR inactive. To be infrared active, they should have change in the dipole moment. That means they should be having some dipole moment. Let us read these points. Vibrational transitions which are accompanied by change in dipole moment of molecules are called infrared active. On the other hand, the vibrational transitions which are not accompanied by change in dipole moment of molecule are not directly observed and these are infrared inactive. This is about the basic introduction of infrared spectroscopy. Thank you for watching.